So, you want to go to Machu Picchu? Okay, let's start with the basics. There are two routes people usually take. Option A, the Inca Trail. 39 kilometers, hike between 2 and 4 days with a guide. All your stuff goes with the porter, leaving you with a curated experience and zero back pain. Most people go with this one, but we're not most people, so we'll go with option two. 5 days, 67 kilometers, 15,000 feet of elevation, probably some altitude sickness, and totally unguided. This is the Salkantay Trek. Wait, am I saying that right? It's August at the time of this trip, which is the middle of winter in South America, so time of year is important to consider when packing. Here's what's coming with me. Sleeping bag, water bladder, down jacket, one thermal top, 4 shirts, 2 long sleeve, 2 short sleeve, all moisture wicking, 3 pairs of underwear, also moisture wicking, hiking pants, leggings, 2 pairs of shorts, 3 pairs of socks, waterproof bags for packing, hiking boots, mask, running buff, head torch, first aid kit, camera and audio gear that goes in a separate bag, chargers, power banks, and batteries for said camera gear, playing cards, bum bag, basic toiletries, nail clippers, journal and pen, travel towel, water bottle, sunglasses, camp suds, vax card, and last but not least, passport. All of this is going in my 48-liter Osprey backpack that has and will only ever see good days. As for neck and shoulder problems, I'll worry about them later because I have a flight to catch. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. If you stuck around this long, then odds are you'll probably stick around for the rest of the video. So, while waiting for my flight to arrive, I'm gonna take you on a trip down memory lane. This is who I'm joining. We met in 2017 teaching abroad in Thailand. Before going our separate ways 5 years ago, we hiked to Everest Base Camp in Nepal. Sam missed his flight, Danny broke his phone, I got really sick, and we almost got stranded in Kathmandu. And it was still one of the most unforgettable experiences ever.
There was a lot of people up here earlier. What do you think happened to them?
I think the Bangkok Bowl came and they ran away.
We planned to meet for this trip in 2020, but... So, 2 years, few canceled flights, and one pandemic later, we have made it. I've debated what kind of story I wanted to tell, whether I wanted this to be sentimental or informative. I'm trying a little of both, so bear with me. I'll try to keep this interesting. All right, let's get the boring stuff out of the way first. You might not need a guide, but what you do need to get into Machu Picchu is a permit. The further ahead you book, the better off you'll be. You're welcome. We got our entrance passes 2 months ahead of time. June, July, and August are peak season, and spaces will fill up if you don't book far enough in advance. Now, entrance is limited, so you're not always guaranteed to get in if you don't arrive early enough. Allegedly, we'll find out in a couple of days.
Didn't see you there, bud.
Oh. Well, this is a great place to start.
This trek will take 5 days, but you need to add time for things like internal flights, bus rides, train travel, and of course,
acclimatization.
Okay, let's talk about our route now. From Lima, we fly to Cusco where we spend a day acclimatizing. From there, we take a bus from Cusco to Molopeta and our hike begins. From Molopeta, we hike to Soriapampa, then to Colpapampa, then to La Playa, then to Aguascalientes, where we finally make our way to Machu Picchu. From there, we catch a train back to Cusco, where we rest for the next day and a half, before flying back to Lima, where we all part ways on this glorious adventure.
Well, that was a mouthful. Honestly, it'll be a miracle if whatever this film turns out to be ever sees the light of day. So, without further ado, here's where our adventure begins.
The road
leading into Mall of Patat is closed, so I'm having to wait for it to reopen. Luckily, it's only another 10 minutes.
It's about 10 minutes ago. We got coca leaves to pass the time.
Instead of the bus, we wound up splitting an Uber. You might have to deal with the occasional road closure, but I will say that it beats a 6-hour bus ride, especially since any time gained for hiking in daylight is ideal. I think we paid 70 sols each, but don't quote me on that. Once you're past any roadblocks, your driver will bring you into town and drop you off.
This is it. This is it. I feel like there was a sign there at some point.
We made it to the trail about 1:30 p.m. If you have your stopping points saved offline, the trek is pretty easy to follow, save for a few hiccups where it'll tell you to hike through a bush or fenced off field or off a cliff. When it comes to that, just follow whatever trail's in front of you. You'll get back on route. Eventually.
We have to hike up that. I'm gonna need to get my trekking poles out.
We finished the day at 22 kilometers with roughly 1,000 meters gained in elevation. If you start feeling your heartbeat in your head, it's the altitude. The locals call it tsurochi. When you do feel this, for the love of God, drink some water. First day of the hike isn't exactly the best time to get a concussion from passing out.
Was it worth it getting kind of lost for like 20 minutes?
Yeah, well, it'll be when we got a head talk, so I'm trying to find a
head. Nightfall came about 6:30 p.m. I'd say it's pretty dangerous to make that bit of the hike in pitch black. About a third of the hike is really flat, a third of the hike is really steep, and the final third of the hike is really flat, but it's also very narrow. We found a lot of cabs driving by that were offering to drive us about halfway up between Molopeta and Soriopampa, and we decided not to. We're good, we're strong, we can just hike up on our own. Not to mention, at that point, we were getting a little bit of altitude sickness, we were running out of water. By the time we got to Soriopampa, everything here was closed. So, that was fun.
Big mistake not taking a cab to get us up here sooner, because lodging is the one thing we kind of misjudged. We took our chances trying to find a place to stay for the night, but since it was way past nightfall, our options were pretty slim. So, we did what anyone stuck in the middle of nowhere in the dead of night would do. We knocked on the first farmhouse that we saw with its lights on, and we asked if we could stay in an unfinished hotel they were building next door for 50 sol a night. This could have ended badly, but it did the trick.
No food, no electricity, but we've woken up. It is close to 9 a.m. Now we're about to hit the road for, give me 1 second. Let's see. Colapapampa. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly.
You are not.
Bear with me. So that is going to be 700 meters of altitude, which I would say is roughly 2,000 feet. Huh. I gotta internalize that.
We're looking roughly at about 14 miles, and we're gonna do a bit of a side trek to Humante Lake. Right now in Soriopampa, we're at 3,850 meters. We're going up to the Alapecha Pass, which will take us to a maximum of 4,580 meters, and then we drop down into Colipapampa at 2,800 meters.
Thanks. You saved me a lot of voiceover time.
Does anyone want a last little chug before we take off? Still got all this water.
Why not?
I'll take a swig. Thanks, bud.
No swigs allowed, just chugs. No consent.
Every time you see Sam on camera, he consented beforehand.
Well, it's no consent in Spanish, Dorian.
No.
Really good.
Nice. Didn't realize we're gonna be so close to it.
In the end, we added about 2 hours to our planned hike that day. Did we regret it? Maybe a little, but the view is great, at least when we stopped to rest. And with the gain in altitude, we did plenty of that.
We have to get to there, and then get somewhere past that, which is higher up. I think we'll be fine. It doesn't, but think of how much better we'll feel tomorrow when we're like, oh, that was a cool story.
Oh, and I also can't say that seeing an avalanche in person isn't worth it. That's not a bad idea. Since we still have a ways to go, let's take a break, and I'll see you in part 2 of Dear God, What Have I Gotten Myself Into? Bye!